Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. In this video, I'd like to talk about how we can improve our programs and our database by using variable-sized character fields instead of fixed-length character fields. When should we choose one data type or another, both in our RPG programs and in our tables or physical files? This is a good question because many times by choosing the correct type of data, we are making our programs faster and saving space. And we already know that this also saves us money. I'm going to show you a few examples that I think will help you. Let's go. Well, first of all, let's talk about RPG. I found in the IBM documentation a page where you can read why you should use variable length fields. And basically, it says that using variable length fields for temporary variables can improve the performance of string operations as well as making your code easier to read since you don't have to save the current length of the field in another variable for substring or use trim to ignore the extra blanks. Also, if a subprocedure is meant to handle string data of different lengths, using variable length fields for parameters and return value of prototyped procedures can enhance both the performance and readability of your calls and your procedures. You will not need to pass any length parameters to get the actual length of the parameter. Well, I have prepared a small program. Let me show it to you. Okay. In this program, only character type variables with fixed size are used. As you can see here and here, okay, and also inside the subprocedure. Well, here I'm trying to concatenate these three variables. Since I want to remove spaces, I have to use trim in all three cases. Okay. In addition, I'm writing in the job log the content of the string along with its size. And also I'm using a subprocedure, this one, that returns two strings passed as parameter concatenated. And I want to add the result to the previous string, of course, ignoring the spaces. Here I'm doing this, okay? String is equal to trim of string concatenate with the trim of the result of the execution of the subprocedure. Well, as you see, it is very simple to do everything, but of course it can be improved as IBM indicates in its documentation. I have created the same program with another name where instead of fixed size fields, I use variable size fields. And this is the result. As you see, it is the same program, okay? What difference do you see? Well, I'm not using trim anywhere, and also it is more readable. And also, if you notice, in the case of using the subprocedure, I concatenate the result using plus and equal, okay? We agree that this is much more readable this way, of course, but also the performance in the case of this program is better. Okay, well, now let's talk about the database. What can we improve in it by using variable size character fields instead of fixed size ones? The response is very clear. We save space. Or I can put it in another way. If you currently have tables or physical files with character fields where you store customer data or items or whatever, then you are wasting space, because the vast majority of these fields are half empty and the white spaces are taking up useless space. Of course, it will depend on the number of fields and the number of records you have stored in the table. This is not always exact. Well, I have prepared, let me close this. I have prepared two different files or tables. Let me show it to you. Well, these are the two DDL of the two files, okay? Well, in these files, will be stored the result of the execution of a program. the result can be positive, in which case nothing will be saved in the field text, okay? But in the case that there is some error, some text will be some text with the error will be saved. As you imagine, most or the vast majority of the executions will not cause an error, and information will only be saved in the text field on some occasion, and of course not always occupying the space of 1000 positions that has the field defined. In the second file, I have defined the field as variable size. I have added some records to the two files, both the same, and I'm going to show you the size of both files. Let me open a green screen. Well, these are the two files, okay? And in both cases, we have, you will see, 19 records, okay? Well, this is the first one, log one. In log one, we have a field that is fixed length, okay? And in this case, we have a total size of 245,000 bytes, okay? Well, in the case of the second file, that is defined with a variable text field, I have also 19 records, and if you can see, the size is less than the before. Okay, so you've seen that the first file is bigger, but the data is the same. Imagine with a file with many more fields or with much more information stored. Okay, well, as you can see in the video, I gave you some reasons to start using variable sized character fields if you haven't already started using them. As you can see, the main reasons are space saving, better performance in both programs and the database, and greater readability in our code. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.